Dire Destroyer here. Hey guys, Dire Destroyer here, and welcome to
the king and his men stole the queen from
three. Let me turn this down a bit. Go away. Anyways, this is the Warriors of the Black Banner. It is a terrorist-based mod that cannot exist on the modding forums because they don't allow any terrorists. There are 5 different factions that I've seen. The biggest and the main one that I'm playing is Caribbean Pirates. And then there's also ISIS. They're part of the Black Net Alliance together. Somali Pirates. The Al-Qaeda Network in Afghanistan. Abbottabad. Damascus. Mogadishu. These are the capitals. The Temple of Poseidon. And then there is the Abu Sayyaf, which are ISIS. I believe they're an ISIS cell in the southern Philippines. But other than that, it's basically the same basic World of Iron, Hoi 4 mod. Same basic countries from that mod in 1939, which is this, called XXXX. As you can see, I'm playing as the Caribbean Pirates, and if you listen closely, I really hope this isn't copyrighted music, guys. If it is, then you will see it removed later on. But I am currently fighting the Germans. It is a very hard-pressed battle, considering all my generals are shit. And sorry if you hear me coughing in the background, guys. I am currently sick. I've had a cold for a week and a half now. So sorry if I sound like shit, because I feel like shit. I felt like total shit for the past week. Okay. And this is really the only basic stuff in the mods, besides certain general. But currently, Al-Qaeda is down. The Japs are pushing a lot. Our Somali brothers are holding out in Mumbai and Riyadh. And ISIS is holding out. Taking a run pretty much all of Africa. I'm trying to push into Italy, which I'm actually doing pretty well. I've taken Naples, I'm working on Rome, and then I just have to take Vienna, and those assholes will be down. As you can see, as far as the Japanese go, I am building up and going on the defensive. I can't fight the Japs. Not on the home turf. Trust me, I've tried. I just can't amass up enough of a force to send over there. So basically what I'm going to be doing is I'm setting up all of these naval defenses. All of this, all along the Pacific coast. And then I'm going to wait. Their generals come up, boom, 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 kill their generals. I might have to hold on to these ports because I'm going to want to send some stuff to take care of those carriers that'll be bombing me. But I'm actually pushing towards Berlin. This is my only general left. Her name is Sonya. Or Sonya, however you want to pronounce it. I've also rebuilt the Magnair line. I call it the Magnair line. It's what everyone else calls it. Some people call it the Magnair line, or the Maginot line, because that's how it's spelled. But it is pronounced the Magnair line. So, yeah, I've rebuilt it, taken Zurich, Milan, Naples. I've been battling the Germans for Palermo for a long while now, and Ajaccio. I'm trying to get that general to get the fuck off of there. That's my city. And I also have some guys holding out over in Baghdad and stuff. And shit, the Japs are coming. They got a bunch of generals coming in hot, boys. It's not mine. I think that's Portugal somehow. Still alive. Ah! That would be why. Yeah, I took out Portugal for their strategic position. Where are the Italians there's a single artillery piece in the water. Strategically move down here and attack Prague. I need to get Amsterdam, because if I take Amsterdam, the German air power in this area will be solely dominated by Berlin. And the Finns are here. Fuck you, Finland. Boom! Pair drop into Amsterdam. Amsterdam is mine. Hold on. No, I don't have enough long range on my strategic bombers out of London. Which means that I'm assuming I won't have enough out of Paris. No. My chances can't strategically bomb Berlin. Or carpet bomb them. Give me back my Zurich. Thank you. Okay, guys. Mine. See, that's one of the things I don't like about WC4. Because in WC3, the assault, you had a 100% chance to continue to attack. But in WC4, assault was only 50% chance on most units. Which I didn't like. I mean, WC4 is great though, but that fact, like, it makes it not as fun for me as World Conqueror 3 is. And as you can see, guys, I'm trying to hold on to Hawaii. I could just do this. Start spamming the place with coastal forts. Boom. But yeah, Britain is holding out for the Allies in that city that the Japs have somehow, have yet to take somehow, and then Australia is holding out in Brisbane. Which I should probably leave alone. I was just trying to take her for that strategic tank spamming place against the Japs. But if I leave Brisbane alone, then the Japs can take it, and then I should be able to take it much more easier. That's what I was trying to say. From there. Now, I do not believe I have any safe. Actually, yes. Ooh. I didn't realize that Mama Jacia from Leon. Now that makes it much easier to take this city. And I can paradrop into it. Useless island city taken. That was totally strategic. Actually, it was, because I now have a strategic island base, and I won't have that dang artillery guy fucking shooting at me every second. But anyway, guys, I'm going to click exit. First of all, as you can see, unlimited money. But I'm going to go in here and show you the rest of these guys. These generals, mainly. They spawn from the wolves' lair. Now you have Hassan, Bin Laden, that guy, al-Baghdadi, and then Jack Sparrow, Pinto, Rigetti, Pinto, Elizabeth Swan, and Hector Barbosa. I want Jack Sparrow. Right now I can only afford Rigetti or Pinto, which are actually good generals on their own. But I'm saving up for the amazing Jack Sparrow. Even though Pinto is a tank general, I could probably use that. Rigetti is infantry, mainly. Swan is Navy. Barbosa is infantry. Hassan is naval. Oh, because he's the Somali pirates. Bin Laden is obviously for Al-Qaeda. He is... Oh, of course he has explosives. This guy's probably for that, street, jungle, mountain, and plain, but no desert, because that is all of the, land in the Philippines is from him. And then there's al-Baghdadi, which is ISIS tanks. ISIS has tanks and artillery. And anyways, I'm gonna just dismiss Falcon real quick, just so I can show you all of these other generals. You have Falcon, then there's also Shadow, Dusty, Barracuda, Salvo, Miriam, Alexa, Gem. I think I'm gonna go for Dusty just because he's one of the characters from Medal of Honor. And Medal of Honor is like my OG thing. Now this is a cost zero. Yes. That was probably the dumb. No, it said that you... I don't know why it automatically directs me to my Bing search, guys. But I don't have enough time. Guys, that bit there where you saw how good I was doing there just shows you that my World Conquerors, or my Easy Tech game in general, my tactics are getting better, a lot better, at least at WC3. You know, obviously the games change. Now this is the one mission that I had a lot of trouble with in base game in WC3. That's because that guy always ended up escaping, and I managed to, like, you know, I could take support there, take that guy, or I could take London, but he escaped out here, and then I ran out of time. But now I can't let him escape. I have to chase him. Give chase! Or... Yeah, I wasn't really good at strafing back then. But, anyways, guys, that will be it for this episode of World Conqueror 3. I hope you all enjoyed this episode. And I will see you all later. Bye!